A lawsuit's pleadings establish what the parties will try to prove at trial. To accommodate issues that arise as a case proceeds, the Federal Rules of Civil Procedure allow the pleadings to be amended throughout the case, up to and including at trial. But the plaintiff in Hardin v. Manitowoc-Forsythe objected to post-trial additions. Darel Hardin worked for Combustion Engineering, or Combustion. He was injured at work while using a push-pull jack manufactured by Columbus-McKinnon Corporation, or Columbus. The jack was attached to a crane made by Manitowoc Engineering, or Engineering. Manitowoc-Forsythe, or Forsythe, ordered the crane and then sold it to Lummus Company. Lummus leased the crane to Combustion. Hardin filed a products liability claim against Columbus, who made the jack, and Forsythe, who sold the jack, in the United States District Court for the District of Kansas. Combustion was immune from suit under Kansas's workers' compensation law. During discovery, Hardin deposed Engineering employee Malcolm Fell. Fell testified that Engineering knew that the jack might be used separately from the crane, but didn't place a warning on the jack or take other safety precautions. Kansas's comparative fault law allowed the relative culpability of non-parties, called phantoms, to be assessed during trial. In the pretrial order, which states the parties' claims and defenses to be litigated at trial, Forsythe asserted that Combustion and Hardin's union had contributed to the accident and that their fault should also be assessed. Thereafter, the district court granted Forsythe's motion to compare the fault of all entities that the evidence showed had contributed to the accident. At trial, Hardin put Fell on the stand and questioned him about Engineering's fault. At the end of the trial, the district court instructed the jury to allocate liability among the parties, as well as phantoms, Combustion, Engineering, and Lummus. Hardin objected to considering the fault of any party not named in the pretrial order, but the district court ruled that the fault attributable to Engineering and Lummus had been tried by consent. The jury allocated fault among Hardin, Columbus, Combustion, Engineering, and Lummus, but found that Forsythe wasn't at fault. Hardin appealed to the Tenth Circuit.